So hello everyone, today we are going to see chapter name is simultaneous linear equations. So in your previous classes you have already seen that equations like ax plus b equal to 0, where a is not equal to 0, are called linear equations in one variable. Okay, so this type of equation ax plus b equal to 0 always gives a unique solution. That is, if we solve this equation, we get a unique value of x or a single value of x. So these type of equations are known as linear equations in one variable. So this solving techniques and solutions of these equations you have already covered in your previous classes. So today we are going to see the solution of simultaneous linear equations in two variables. Okay, so let's suppose equation ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Equation ax plus by plus c equal to 0, where a is not equal to 0 and b is not equal to 0. That means if a and b are non-zero numbers, then equation ax plus by plus c is known as linear equation in two variables. Linear equation in two variables, because two variables, okay. This is called linear equations in two variables because here we have two variables x and y whose value are unknown, or we also call it x and y as variables or unknowns. Okay, so this is a linear equations because power of x here is 1 and power of y or degree of y is 1. Okay, so this equation have maximum degree 1 and have two unknowns. That's why it is known as linear equation in two variables. Okay, so ax plus by plus c equal to 0 type equations always called as linear equations in two variables. Let's suppose we are taking an example, 2x plus 3y plus 5 equal to 0. Here coefficient of x and coefficient of y is non-zero. What we have taken as condition, a is not equal to 0, b is not equal to 0. Here coefficient of x is not equal to 0, that is 2, and coefficient of y is 3. So this equation is an example of linear equation in two variables, in x and y. Okay, so a linear equation in one variable always gives a unique solution or single solution, but a single linear equation in two variables gives infinite solutions or have infinite number of solutions. So here we are going to see how many values of x and y will satisfy this equation. Okay, so I am just taking x as 1. If I am taking x as 1, we can calculate the value of y here. So put x is equal to 1 here, we get 2 into 1 plus 3y plus 5 equal to 0. This 3y will be equal to, taking this as right hand side, so it will become 5 plus 2, 7, so it will be minus 7, and y will be minus 7 by 3. Okay, so if x is 1, then y will be minus 7 by 3. Okay, now I am taking x as 2. So if you take x equal to 2, then you will get value of y. Put this value x equal to 2 in this equation, we'll get 2 into 2 plus 3y plus 5 equal to 0. That is 3y equal to 5 plus 4. 2 into 2, 4. 4 plus 5, 9. So 9 going right side, that become negative. 3y equal to minus 9, or we can say y equal to minus 9 by 3, and this will become minus 3. So I am taking x equal to 2 and getting y equal to minus 3. Here I got two solutions, and if you put x equal to 3 or any value, x equal to 1.5 or x equal to 1.55555, you'll always get a value of y. So we can say equation in two variables, single linear equation in two variables gives infinite number of solutions always. Okay, but in case of single linear equations in one variable, variables gives always a single solution or a unique solution. Okay, so this was the case when a single linear equation is given, that means that equation have infinite number of solutions. Okay, so if a equation have some solutions, then that equation is known as consistent, and if a equation have no solution, that equation is called inconsistent. But in case of linear equations, we will not see any case of inconsistent here. Only consistent case we'll see. Okay, so let's suppose ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is a linear equation in two variables, and values of x equal to alpha and y equal to beta are the solution of this equation. So if these are the solution, okay, so if x equal to alpha and y equal to beta are the solution of this equation ax plus by plus c equal to 0, so these values will satisfy this equation. That means if we put x equal to alpha and y equal to beta in left hand side, it will become 0. Okay, so put here x equal to alpha and y equal to beta, so it will become a into alpha plus b into beta plus c, and this will become a alpha plus b beta plus c. And if x equal to alpha, y equal to beta is a solution of this linear equation, then this value must be equal to 0. So if any numbers or any number are the solution of a linear equation, that means that numbers will satisfy this that equation. Okay, so these type of equations are called these type of equations are called linear equations in two variables. And if we take a pair of linear equations in two variables, okay, now I am taking a pair of two equations. Okay, so let's suppose a equation is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, and second equation is a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. So here a1x plus b1y plus c1 is a first equation in two, this is a linear equation in two variables, x and y, equation 1. And a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0 is another equation in unknowns x and y, or variables x and y. And this is a linear equation because power is 1. So this is a linear equation in two variables, and this is also a linear equation in two variables. So we have, if we have together two equations in x and y, then these type of equations are known as simultaneous linear equations. Okay, so our task is how to solve simultaneous linear equations. Okay, so we have three techniques to solve simultaneous linear equations. Technique one is by using substitution method, and method two is elimination method, and third is cross multiplication method. So method 1 and method 2 are very important because you will always get these type of equations in your further classes. So you have to learn these equations, solving technique of these equations by either substitution method or elimination method. So you just have to focus. Today's lecture we will only focus on substitution method, and next classes we will see elimination method and cross multiplication method. So today's class we are going to focus how to solve a simultaneous linear equations or a pair of linear equation in two variables by substitution method. Okay, so here we are going to see how to solve a pair of linear equations in two variables by substitution method. So you have to focus how I am going to solve this pair of equations. So first of all, we just mark equation 1 as 1 and this equation as 2. Okay, so here we have two variables, x and y, and we want to calculate the values of x and y. Okay, so what value of x and y will satisfy this equation? So first of all, we have to mark this equation as 1 and equation 2 as equation 2. Okay, so I am going to solve equation 1. Okay, so we'll write solving equation 1. So here 4x minus 3y equal to 8. So our first task is calculate either x or y and put that value of x or y in equation second equation. Okay. So I am going to calculate the value of x here, value of x from this expression. So this will be 4x equal to 8 plus 3y. Now I want to calculate x. So x will be 8 plus 3y divided by 4. Okay. So from equation 1 we got value of x equal to 8 plus 3y equal to 4. Now I am going to put this value of x in expression 2. So I will get or will write putting value of x in equation 2. Okay. Equation 2 is x minus 2y equal to minus 3. We got from equation 1 x as 8 plus 3y divided by 4. So it will be 8 plus 3y divided by 4 minus 2y equal to minus 3. Now just take 4 as LCM because 2y divided by 1 is here. So LCM of 1 and 4 will be 4. Okay. So take 4 as LCM, we'll get 8 plus 3y minus 4 multiplied with 2, 8y equal to minus 3. Now 3y minus 8y will give minus 5, minus 5y, and this 8 will remain here. 8 minus 5y will be equal to 4 into minus 3, minus 12. Okay, so this reduced in as equation of linear equation in one variables. This equation is a linear equation in one variable where we have to find the value of y. So next solve this equation and it will be like 5y. Take 5y right side and 12 minus 12 in left side. So it will become 5y equal to 8 plus 12. 8 plus 12 and this will be 20. 5y equal to 20. If 5y equal to 20, then y will be equal to 20 by 5, that is 4. Okay, so here we got value of y equal to 4. Put this value of y in expression this. Okay, got value of y. So put y equal to 4 here and we will get x equal to 8 plus 3 into y is 4. So this will be 4 divided by 4. Now x will be equal to 8 plus 12. 8 plus 12 divided by 4, or this will be 20 by 4, or we can say y x equal to 5. So from this expression we got x equal to 5 and solving this we got y equal to 4. So these two values of x or x and y, value of x equal to 5 and value of y equal to 4 is the solution of this these two equations. So this is known as the solution of equation 1 and 2, x equal to 5 and y equal to 4. We can also check our answer by putting values of x and y in this expression. So I told that if this is the solution of this expression, that means these values will satisfy this equation. So put the value of x equal to 5 and y equal to 4 in this expression. So we'll get 4 into 5 minus 3 into 4, or we will get 20 minus 12. 20 minus 12 is 8, and we got left hand side 8 and right hand side it is 8. So that means our equation is, or our solution is correct. Okay, so these two, these x equal to 5 and y equal to 4 is the solution of this. Okay, so we have another one more question. Root 2x plus root 3y equal to 0 and root 3x minus root 8y equal to 0, and we want to find the values of x and y. Here this equation is in terms of root, so no problem. Mark this equation expression as equation 1 and this expression as equation 2. Now our same concept will apply. Okay, we will apply same concept solving equation 1. So when we'll solve this, we'll get root 2x plus root 3y equal to 0, or root 2x will be equal to minus root 3y, and the value of x from this expression will be x equal to minus root 3 divided by root 2y. Okay, so we will get x in terms of y as x equal to minus root 3 divided by root 2y. So mark this expression as equation 3. Now we will put the value of x in expression 2. So first of all, we solve equation 1 and find the value of x, and that value of x put in an second equation. By putting value of x here, so we'll write putting the value of x from equation 2 from equation 3 in equation 2. Okay, equation 2 is root 3x minus root 8y equal to 0. Put the value of x here, so this will be root 3 into minus root 3 divided by root 2y equal to minus root 8y equal to 0. Okay, so root 3 into minus root 3 will become minus 3y, and this root 2 will get multiplied with minus root 2 into root 8y, and LCM as root 2 equal to 0. Okay, so here we have 1, just cross multiply this expression, we will get minus 3y minus, we can write root 2, root 8 as 2 root 2. Okay, we can write root 8 as 2 root 2. So put the value of root 8 as 2 root 2 here. So we will get 3y minus root 2 into 2 root 2 y equal to 0. Okay, so 2 into root 2 into root 2 will be 2, and 2 multiplied with 2 will be minus 4. So here we will get minus 3y minus 4y equal to 0, or minus 4 minus 7, minus 7y equal to 0, or y equal to 0. So the value of y equal to 0 is the solution of this equation. Now we want to calculate the value of x. So put the value of y here in expression 3. So we will get x as minus root 3 by root 2 into 0, or equal to 0. So x equal to 0 and y equal to 0 is the solution of x equal to 0 and y equal to 0 is the solution of these two linear equations in two variables, and this type of solutions is known as trivial solution, x equal to 0, y equal to 0. Okay, so these expressions have solution x equal to 0. Okay, so we have one more problem, and the expression 1 is b by ax plus a by by equal to a square plus b square, and expression 2 is x plus y equal to 2ab. Okay, so our first aim is to just mark this expression 1 as equation 1 and expression 2 as equation 2. Now we will repeat our concept, just solving equation 1. Okay, so we are going to solve equation 1 to get one variable in terms of other. Okay, so this will be b by a x will be equal to a square plus b square minus a by b y. Okay, now find the value of x from here. So x will be equal to a by b, just multiplying this as cross multiplying. So x will be a by b, a square plus b square minus a divided by b y. Okay, so mark it as equation 3. Okay, now we got value of x in terms of y as this. So put this value of x in equation 2. Always, if you are solving equation 1 and getting some one variable, so put that value in another equation. Okay, so if I am solving first equation 2, so the value will put in equation 1. Okay, here I am solving equation 1, so that's why I am putting this value in equation 2. Okay, so the value of x, put it in equation 2. So now putting value of x in equation 2. So equation 2 is x plus y equal to 2ab. Now put value x equal to this. So x is a by b plus a by b into a square plus b square minus a by b x y plus y equal to
2ab.
This equation is in terms of single variable, and that single variable is y. So by solving this, we will get y. Okay. So I am going to multiply this a by b inside the bracket. So we will get a cube divided by b. Okay. Plus a b square divided by b minus a square y divided by b square. Okay. Plus y equal to 2ab. By multiplying this a by b inside the bracket, we will get a cube by b plus ab square by b minus a square by b square y plus y equal to 2ab. Now, just took b square as LCM. Okay. So here we will get b square as LCM. So take b square as LCM and we will get a cube into b, because here is b, here is b square, so we'll multiply with b. A cube plus a cube into b plus a b cube minus a square y plus b square y equal to 2ab. Okay. Now multiply this b square in 2ab, so we will get a cube b plus a b cube minus a square y plus b square y equal to 2ab cube. B square into b, b cube. Okay, so we have one more ab cube, and here we have 2ab cube. So this, if we take this value this side, so it will become negative, and 2ab ab cube minus ab cube will be ab cubes. Okay, so here if we taking y as common, so we'll get b square minus a square. Okay, I am solving this. So taking y as common, so we'll get b square as positive and a square as negative. So I have taken b square minus a square. Okay. Now ab cube, taking this side, so this 2ab cube minus ab cube will become ab cube. Now a cube b will become a cube minus a cube b. Okay. Now put y, take y as single, so y will be equal to ab cube. Here ab and ab is common, so if we take ab as common, so we will get b square minus a square, and one more b square minus a square we have, so this will go in denominator, so it will become b square minus a square. Now solving this, we'll get y as ab. Now we got y as ab. So put this y equal to ab in expression 3 and we will get value of x. Okay, so next we will write as putting the value of y is equal to ab in equation 3. So we will get x equal to a by b into a square plus b square minus a by b into y is ab. Okay, so this will be as x equal to a by b into a square plus b square minus a into a will become minus a square. So if you solve, a square plus a square plus a square and minus a square will get cancel out, and here a by b multiplied with b square, so a by b multiplied with b square, b and b getting cancel out, and we'll get finally ab. Okay, so we got x equal to ab, and we have already calculated y as ab. So the solution of these two expression is x equal to ab and y equal to ab. Okay, so this is the solution of these two equations by substitution method. So next you have to try some more questions or exercise 1 by yourself, okay, by using substitution method. And next lecture we will continue as solution of simultaneous linear equations by elimination method. Okay.